Quite a few outstanding automobile designs have been, at some point, regarded as works of art. But how many cars have been styled by an actual artist? Flaminio Bertoni, born in northern Italy but emigrated to Paris by 1931, sought recognition for his artistic endeavors all his life. Yet, to this day, he remains pretty much an unknown for everyone except Citroën enthusiasts, who, like me, venerate him for having styled the marque's most iconic models. The Museo Flaminio Bertoni, hosted within the larger Volandia Museum complex, successfully strikes a delicate balance between Bertoni the artist and Bertoni the industrial designer by displaying the cars together with several of Bertoni's sculptures in the same area. Attracted by sculpture since a young age, Bertoni expressed his ideas at Citroën's Bureau d'Études mainly through scale models. His sketches look and feel like the preparatory sketches of a sculpture, quickly fixing his ideas on paper before carving them in three dimensions. Legend has it that Bertoni created the Traction Avance shape within a single night of feverish work on a scale model that André Citroën approved the following day. Nowadays, it's hard to imagine just how sleek, rakish and modern the Citroën Traction Avant looked in 1934 upon its presentation. Thanks to its unibody construction and front-wheel drive configuration, it sat so low that it didn't need running boards on the sides, which was quite radical for a family saloon at the time. The Traction on display is perhaps one of the most common models of the range, a post-war 11BL in black. Equipped with a 1.9L inline-4 engine, this is a so-called Légère model, which differs from the regular 11B model by its narrower track and shorter wheelbase. The 2CV is instead represented by a special model from 1990, the very last year of production. And this is kind of a pity, as I think an earlier model would have been a better fit with the rest of the exhibition. Although much of the 2CV's aesthetic was pretty much defined by its engineering parameters, Bertoni's touch nevertheless made it look less of a farmer's tool than the original prototypes. But the elephant in the room, or perhaps more appropriately in this case, the shark, is Her Majesty the DS. Like the Traction Avant it was meant to replace, the DS was the brainchild of chief engineer André Lefebvre, who tasked Bertoni to develop a shape as aerodynamic as a raindrop. That's what led Bertoni to seek inspiration from marine creatures. The DS had no imposing radiator grille, but a shallow mouth under a finely sculpted front bumper, with headlights that look like eyes, almost popping out of a smooth body that gently tapers towards the tail. The DS became an overnight sensation when it was unveiled at the Paris Motor Show in October 1955, gaining worldwide acclaim as an absolute design masterpiece. However, Bertoni resented not having his contribution publicly recognized by Citroën, which, in keeping with period industry practice, never gave public credit to individuals within its organization. The Black Beauty on display is a rare early DS19, still equipped with a plexiglass rear window due to Citroën's supplier having yet to learn how to manufacture such a wraparound, curvy piece of glass. Although later DS models were improved in all areas, these early models are the ones that fascinate me the most, as we so rarely see them. Flaminio Bertoni was never fully satisfied with the DS rear end, which he had to hastily modify in the last stages of development, coming up with these lovely cone-shaped indicator mounts. Funnily enough though, this is the part of the car that perhaps changed less over the model's nearly 20 years of production. Coherently with his flamboyant, contrarian character, Flaminio Bertoni's favorite creation wasn't the celebrated DS though, but the rather baroque and contrived AMI 6, presented in 1961. For how much I love classic Citroëns, pretty is not a word I'd use to describe the AMI 6. It has, however, charm and personality by the bucket load, that's for sure. The model's defining feature certainly is the inverted rear window, which is a clever solution to an apparently insurmountable problem, designing a three-box saloon within the size limitations of the two CV's chassis. Within the given length, a more conventional roof design would have severely limited the headroom for the rear passengers, so Bertoni came up with this unmistakable shape. It may not win any beauty contest, but the AMI 6 was a cleverly designed car and also Bertoni's last one. Flaminio Bertoni was suddenly killed by a stroke on February the 7th, 1964. From then on, the reins of Citroën's design were taken by Roberto Prohn. But that's a story for another time.